amazing.
Salisbury Cathedral in matches. Isn't it interesting how they never made Hamlet a hero of one of their advertisements?
No, it's not.
I can see it quite clearly in my mind's eye. The gloomy Dane on the battlements, soliloquizing in the original Danish. To be or not to be, it is the question whether it is nobler in the man to serve the slings and arrows of outrageous purity, you know, bother it, and then lighting up. No more gloomy Dane. I don't understand girls today. Or chickens. Did you get ideas sent in by members of the public?
This next one was the idea of a colonel in the Guards. He was paid with, quote, a crate of rather indifferent wine, unquote, and spit in a bucket.
Happiness is a cigar called Hamlet, the mild cigar.
I mean, given the date, surely you could have done a bit of George Orwell. I mean, Winston Smith and the...
Sing a thank you song, court sailors unsurpassed, these bargains cannot...
Court's biggest ever summer sale starts on Saturday at 9 a.m.
I would just a nipper when our king come to throne. Me, mum and dad put in some hours that day, baking ovis and getting sandwiches ready for party. Come tea time, they look fair jiggered. So I told me dad to look on bright side. He'd work up an healthy appetite for his ovis. Cheeky monkey, he said. But we didn't have to dig into them sandwiches.
Ovis, it's as good today as it's always been.
You house ain't got no atmosphere. Give me something old. New movies ain't so hot. Most of them ain't got no plot. Now I won't touch a beverage that's got no heritage.
Give me something old.
Gamers, old English cider. The older, the better. Andrex Ultra is an advanced new kitchen towel. It comes in a one-roll pack, is almost twice as long as most other quality kitchen rolls, and is much more absorbent, as I'm about to demonstrate. Notice how quickly Andrex Ultra sucks up water compared with the other quality kitchen towel.
Thank you.
In 35 minutes, our comedy classic brings back television's favourite junkmen, Steptoe and Son. That's at 10:30, and follows an extended main news of the evening now with John Humphreys.
Ceasefire in the Falklands. The Argentine junta says the fighting stopped until tomorrow afternoon. No confirmation from London. General Moore, his troops bearing down on Port Stanley, meets General Menendez, his troops on the run. We have pictures of British reinforcements going ashore at the San Carlos bridgehead. And Mrs. Thatcher leaves for the Commons. A statement's expected there within the next half hour. Good evening. There is no fighting tonight on the Falkland Islands. According to an official communique from the military junta in Buenos Aires, a temporary ceasefire has been agreed. That has not been confirmed by the government here. The announcement of the ceasefire came from Buenos Aires after a meeting between the British commander, General Moore, and the Argentine commander, General Menendez. The meeting had apparently been suggested by General Moore, and Menendez agreed after consulting his government in Buenos Aires. A short time ago, it was reported that General Menendez had flown to Buenos Aires, the first time he is known to have left the Falklands since the Argentine invasion on April the 2nd. The first news of the ceasefire came from our correspondent, Brian Walker. He's just sent us this report.
It's now clear that a ceasefire has been agreed to give General Mario Menendez, the Argentine military commander in the Falklands, time to consult with President Galtieri and the other members of the junta here in Buenos Aires. General Menendez was allowed to fly out of the Falklands to the capital this afternoon and is expected to arrive here about now. The ceasefire is described here as virtual and not complete. Indeed, the previous official communique, less than an hour earlier, reported that fierce fighting was still going on the outskirts of Stanley, although it's very possible that this information is now out of date. The ceasefire is supposed to come to an end at 2 o'clock British summer time tomorrow afternoon, when Menendez is expected back on the islands with the junta's terms for a more permanent end to the fighting. Clearly, the junta are going to try to bargain to avoid an outright surrender. When Menendez this afternoon asked the junta's permission to agree to General Moore's invitation for a meeting, the high command agreed, providing he did nothing to harm the reputation of the armed forces. Throughout the day, a spate of military communiques prepared Argentine public opinion for this moment. They recorded a steady British advance, first to the heights above Stanley, and then to the outskirts of the town itself. Authoritative reports reaching Buenos Aires say that the British are actually in the town itself at this moment. So in the next few hours, the Argentine junta will be trying to save face and perhaps preserve their position. Diplomatic activity is also said here to be underway to try to achieve a more permanent ceasefire that a badly battered Argentina feels it can accept.
Tonight's developments came after a day of fierce fighting on the Falklands, during which the British forces made considerable new advances towards the last remaining objective, Port Stanley. Earlier this evening, Mr. John Knott, the Defence Secretary, had announced that Marines and paratroops had captured more key positions, Wireless Ridge to the northwest and Tumbledown and Mount William to the south. He said Argentine soldiers were in full retreat. Later reports from Buenos Aires said British troops were now in the streets of the capital itself. During the first phase of the assault on the capital over the weekend, more than 20 British soldiers were killed, according to a report from the Press Association. They say about 50 Argentine soldiers were also killed as British troops